An air of confidence to the Suns as they arrived earlier today. Playing in front of their home fans always puts a bounce in your step. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports, and thanks for joining us on this fine Thursday afternoon. With Brett Berry and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Andrew Wiggins, in his eighth season, was named an All-Star starter. That's the second longest wait ever after Kyle Lowry. Wiggins said, in Golden State, I'm around greatness, and those guys believe in me. Offensively, they trust me with the ball, and defensively, I guard the other team's best player. That right there is motivating. Kevin?
Indeed it is. Thank you, DA. And with these teams, Brent, we have a couple of the deepest rosters in the NBA, and not many coaches can go as far down the bench as these two.
Well, a major advantage if you have multiple guys that you have tremendous confidence in to go out there and be switchable, be able to pass, move, and initiate the offense. That's a luxury for a lot of coaches to be able to adapt that way.
Now, Golden State's starting five. The three great shooters out there for him, Curry and Poole in the backcourt with Thompson at the three.
Here we go.
And Drew Wiggins is out there with Draymond Green. And for Phoenix, Ball and Booker, the talented backcourt pair. Up it forward, they'll have Bridges and Crowder. And it's Ayton in at the center. Now here's Paul. Bridges kicks to Paul. Plays it up off the glass.
That's why Chris Paul is so special, is because he can just navigate around pick and rolls, find open areas, and there's just no defense for that.
Here's Wiggins. Inside, here's Thompson, and Thompson throws it down.
Making the most of the screen, that's how it's done.
And it's in the perfect spot, Greg. Frees him up to get all the way to the bucket.
Really not enough help there, lack of communication on the backside.
And here are the Suns now. The Warriors making the shot. Bridges passes to Ayton. Up and in on the layup.
The coaching staff has to like that as he picks apart the defense there in the pick and roll play.
After being selected first overall in the 2018 draft, some teams question if DeAndre Ayton was worthy of that.
Well, it took time for Ayton to find his comfort zone and all of a sudden became a key piece that nobody's questioning much anymore as an inside rebounder, rim protector, a guy who can score at a high level when asked to. Booker's all-around game is really coming together. Nice play there.
Just around a minute and a half into the first quarter. Outside, Green. Outside, Curry. The three. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
So active from behind the arc, and he's going to be there all night long. Curry needs just a bit of separation. He'll let it fire.
Now here's Booker. Ayton a screen on Poole. Here's Booker. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
First personal foul.
And it goes on Draymond Green.
Oh, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
The Suns shooting their first free throws of the game.
And they had a lot of success a season ago as a team, hitting about 80% of their free throws.
Just thinking aloud about the best teams of my lifetime, that 2017 Warriors are way up there. That first year KD was with Golden State.
Both free throws good from Booker. And the title-winning 2017 Warriors, Brent Berry, what made them special?
Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green. I mean, all these guys in their prime, Kevin, but to me, it's what Steve created there stylistically. The fact that they played with so much freedom, so much enjoyment. You don't see that all that often. So the Warriors reaching the crown with that kind of consistency and character, that's what made it special.
And the Suns get it back. Just couldn't take the lid off. They had their chances, but came up empty. Green dishes to Curry. Three-pointer. Bridges with the board.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
down low. Here's Ayton, and they pick up two. 6 points for DeAndre Ayton.
Well, you bump me, and I'm going to bump you back as Ayton, not afraid to get physical with the defender.
And you love seeing that great mobile one drive a second time.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself.
Now here's Thompson to the paint, and Green slams it in.
Gotta love the effort there. An undersized four who can really make things happen with that leaping ability.
Bridges outside. Here's Ayton. Good on the shot. Ayton's got 8 points.
Well, if Ayton continues to play with that kind of effort, possession by possession, he's a real tough cover.
Curry against Paul. Curry looking around. Puts up a three. Rebounded by DeAndre Ayton. Ayton's got 6 rebounds now in the game. A nice shot by Booker.
Devin Booker will score by any means necessary, and that time over decent defense, getting the contact.
Here's Wiggins. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And that's not nearly the kind of defense that's going to prevent a player of his ability from scoring.
1:35 left to play in the first. Here's Paul Green with the block.
And Green plays with tremendous edge on the defensive end of the floor.
Great effort and gets in a little razzle-dazzle at the end of that one.
Yeah, why not? Show a little creativity, get inside, move that ball around, just make sure you score.
And Phoenix with a whole new group on the floor. Then for the Warriors, Kevon Looney is checked in for Green. Kuminga comes in for Thompson. And it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Jordan Poole. Suns leading by three. Payne looking around. Charge a screen on Kurt. He takes it in. Payne. And off the glass. That one's good.
Payne, one of those guys like a water bug, just slippery on the inside, and you can't find him. But you like the role that Cam has accepted as a guy who comes in and gives immediate energy and impact to the offense. He does a little bit of everything, but he certainly is a spark plug.
Now here's Wiggins. Looney with the bucket.
Nothing to force here. Wiggins patient. He found the open man.
And here's Payne. Charge with the screen for Payne. Wiggins with the block. Outside Kerr. 26 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Looney with it, and it's Johnson picking him up. Kuminga kicks to Kerr. Can't tie it up as that one's no good.
Well, it isn't for a lack of effort when it comes to getting up the three-pointers, but not much to show for it. He's going to lose the green light here very early in this game if this keeps up.
DeAndre, he has been the guy making things happen for the Phoenix Suns. Scoring, rebounding, he was all over the place during that quarter. They are riding his performance right now. Right back after this break.
Fans, please give a big round of applause for your Suns youth dance team.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Phoenix.
And, guys, they've done a great job feeding their bigs inside. They are just punishing the opposition in the paint.
I love the passing that they displayed at the start of the game. Great ball movement that's opening up some chances without really getting deep into the execution.
So on the floor for Golden State to begin the second quarter. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Green. Then there's Dante DiVincenzo. Then there's Jonathan Kuminga. And it's Thompson in at the two spot. Thompson misses. Suns lean by three. Now here's Paul. Pass to Johnson. Takes a three. Warriors with the rebound.
Ooh, he missed an easy chance to put some points on the board. He won't get a much better look at that kind of shot again here probably tonight.
DiVincenzo can't hit it. And here's Bridges. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. Paul finds Johnson. Back to Paul. Suns moving the ball around. Ayton, the pass to Paul. Down to five on the shot clock. The Frank Chris Paul is undoubtedly one of the smartest players in the NBA.
And that's why he's been able to maintain such a high level of play for so long. As one of his teammates said, he has an IQ that's going to keep him on the floor until he's 50.
First one falls for him.
And we talk about the playmaking ability of CP3. Third all-time in career assists, second all-time in career assist percentage, and he looks far from done.
And the Warriors making a change here. Poole's checked in. Both free throws good from Paul. And Greg, what separates Paul from the other two guys that have more career assists is that Paul also averaged 18 points a game.
And he scores with efficiency. Really a one-of-a-kind talent. When he finally does decide to hang him up, I think he'd make a great head coach as well.
Now, here's Green to the inside. The 9-foot shot. Yep, it goes in, and the Suns' lead is cut to just 3 points on the basket from Kuminga.
Now, Draymond Green patient enough to know when his teammates are running around, at some point one's going to break open, then he finds him.
Here's Booker. Here's Ayton. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two. Ayton's got 10 points in the game. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
DiVincenzo against Paul. Here's Poole. Drives to the hoop. Makes it off the glass.
And Poole streaking past the defense. Looked like he had another gear he got to.
Suns leading by three. Paul surveying the floor. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. You know, it seems like we're seeing more teams, Brent, use zone defense these days. Not too long ago, zone was almost non-existent in the league.
Well, Kevin, you couldn't play zone. Even though there were zone principles in man-to-man defense, it used to be an illegal defense to set up in a 2-3 zone that you see teams doing nowadays. I'm very interested if the league does, in fact, do away with illegal defense and allow coaches to use whatever defensive scheme they need to do to slow up their opposition. It might do something in terms of producing more shots so we don't get stagnation with just threes all the time. We'll see if that happens.
Now here's Wiseman. Outside, Green. To the middle. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
And a nice show of strength there for Jordan Poole. After missing the playoffs for 10 consecutive seasons, boy, the Suns not only got to the postseason in 21, they made it all the way to the finals. So what a turnaround for that franchise.
It's been quite a turnaround, hasn't it, Brent, for Phoenix? Ever since they acquired Chris Paul in that trade from Oklahoma City, they've been a different team.
Yeah, and I don't think you can really give enough credit to what it is that Chris Paul has brought, along with the combination and relationship that he has with Monty Williams. I mean, that leadership with that young roster and giving those guys belief has elevated the play of everybody who's put on that uniform.
Here's Poole. Following the score by Phoenix. Yep, that one goes.
And his presence as a scorer, it just has a calming effect for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need one.
Now here's Booker. 6 points for him. Wiseman with the rebound.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Now DiVincenzo. He's still scoreless so far in this one. They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
Superb job by Clay to draw the contact for the and-one opportunity. Great focus on the play.
The Warriors have shot just one free throw earlier, one for one in the game. Here's what Phoenix has got going on right now. Šarić checked in for Ayton. Torrey Craig comes in for Bridges. Landry Shamet checked in for Devin Booker. And Cameron Payne subbed in for Chris Paul. And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point.
And sitting out for over 2 years due to devastating injuries. It is so good to see Klay Thompson back on the court.
I love it, and he's been so competitive with himself to fight through this injury and also to regain that form. There had to have been a lot of questions with over 900 days off. Can I get back to that level? And I believe that he wasn't even fully healthy during the finals, so we're going to see a more confident Klay this year.
And no matter what, one of the big positives they can take away from this game is how well they perform at the line.
Šarić nails them both.
And you can tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
Outside Curry. Pass to Thompson. Wiseman with the ball. Covered by Šarić. Out of bounds. Phoenix takes possession. And the Warriors making a change here. Wiggins is checked in.
Andrew Wiggins.
And here are the Suns now.
2 minutes
remaining with it. Šarić, a screen on Curry. Here's Payne, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Campaign just a grinder and has stuck with it. His career arc is quite interesting. Spent time in the G League, and a few years back he was out of the league. Now he's back, he's confident, he's dependable, and he's a huge part of a team playing winning basketball.
That's good from Payne. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Warriors trail by three. Right side Curry. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Well, if Steph Curry works as hard at golf when he has the time as he did in shooting the basketball, I don't know. He's no slouch on the golf course.
There was a story, Brent, a couple years ago that Steph Curry's best round of golf came during the NBA Finals. Had you heard that?
I did hear that, but I also heard that Andre Iguodala has a major role in how that happened. Andre was taking up his golf game when they were battling the Cavs in 2018. And I think that competitive spirit of Steph's took over. He wanted to take Andre on, and he got out there during the finals.
Now, here's Shamet. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Šarić, that's good.
Catch and shoot opportunity for Dario, and he doesn't waste it.
And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for Golden State. It's a 5-point game. Pass to Wiggins. The pass to Looney for Craig. And again, no good by Golden State. Suns leading by five. Outside Crowder. Here's Šarić. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, two for two.
Riding through the contact, Dario does a great job that time.
50 seconds left in the second quarter. It's three outside. Now just 1 for 7 with that miss. Tough night so far. Wiggins against Gray. Passes to Crowder. Shamet on the wing. Five on the clock. Over Wiseman. And the Suns tack on two more.
It's rare for a young player to enter the league that has this polished of a shot. Shamet getting it done.
Now here's Curry. Tight defense on him. DiVincenzo. looking to end the run. And so it's Phoenix, ahead by nine as the quarter comes to a close. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the Sun. All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports. If you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books, one half to go. DeAndre Ayton has been sensational.
In those first two quarters, he was pretty much an automatic bucket getter if he got it down low on the block.
Yeah, we'll see if the double teams start to come here in the second half to make them adjust offensively, but he's going to keep going at it.
Ball and Booker, the talented backcourt pair. Ayton is the pivot, and Crowder slides in at the four. And it's Bridges in at the small forward position. That's the five to begin the second half for Monty Williams. Pass to Ayton. Green with the block. Curry dishes to Wiggins. Inside, Green, and Green slams it in.
And Wiggins' game continues to evolve. You saw that right there. Good eye movement, found the shooter.
Outside, Crowder. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Ayton sets the pick for Crowder. Kicks it out to Paul. Phoenix needs to get off a shot. Here's Ayton. Got him with the pump fake, but couldn't finish. Warriors trail by seven. Outside for Curry. Buries the long-range jumper. Curry's got 7 points in the game.
A three-point specialist can't let Curry get any space to fire from the corner. That's a recipe for disaster.
Phoenix calls timeout. Cameron Johnson's checked in for Crowder. Quarter of play with just over a minute and a half gone by. Paul with the buckets.
So tough to keep up with the energy of Chris Paul at the point guard position, especially when he's handling the rock like that.
Here's Curry with the three, trains the three-pointer. 10 points for him.
That's pretty much not how they want to defend the three-point line. Somebody's got a shadow one out there.
Paul outside, and there's the pass to Ayton. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
Think about the next few years. How much more complete will Ayton get? There's some indicators there.
Well, many thought the Suns would let Ayton walk as a restricted free agent, but they had no hesitation matching the offer to bring him back. It looks like he'll be a Sun for the foreseeable future.
Here's Wiggins, and the layup's good off the glass.
Wiggins getting the space and then does not hesitate before firing that one.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Here's Paul, and the Suns tack on 2 more.
Well, looking into the gaps of the defense there, he's not going to miss many of those when he gets to that range.
Curry against Paul. Here's Wiggins. Kicks it to Green. Just five to shoot. This one for three. And it's Wiggins missing. And so it's Paul bringing it up for Phoenix. Their biggest lead of the game was nine. Passes it to Ayton. The nine-foot shot. Another one falls for Phoenix.
Such a tremendous physical profile that Ayton has. He's getting it done down low.
Ball against Kurt. Down low, Wiggins gets to Green. Green with a screen for Poole. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. That one on Ayton.
And Poole just blowing through contact.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
And over the course of last year, he was up over 90%. And with a stroke like that, you see why.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first.
And Jordan Poole has stepped onto the NBA stage and not ever backed down from a challenge. He plays with tremendous confidence.
Here's what Phoenix has got going on right now. Šarić comes in for DeAndre Ayton, and it's Payne in for Paul. Golden State also making some changes. Looney's checked in for Wiggins. Jonathan Kuminga comes in for Klay Thompson. And it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Stephen Curry. DiVincenzo against Booker. Šarić, a screen on DiVincenzo. Booker. It's rebounded by Golden State.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
Green in the post. Šarić is there. And with that shot, the Suns lead is cut down to just three in the basket from Green. Pass to Bridges. Booker. He drains it as the shot clock ticks down. Booker's got eight. Warriors trail by five. And here is DiVincenzo. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. And Poole gets it to go.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the three-point line.
Šarić outside. Fires the three. DiVincenzo with the rebound. The Warriors have gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the third. A 75% clip. Pass to Looney. Green in the post. Defended by Booker. Shots good by Green.
Got to admire Draymond Green being fearless that time. No problem going straight at the defense.
There's 31 seconds left to play in the third. Here's Payne. Green with the block. Now here's Poole. 12 points for him. Kuminga. The pass to Green. It's over Payne. That one wide left. It's all tied in Phoenix. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter.
The Warriors, 45.
Let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
You know, anytime a guy's in the post and the teammates know he's unselfish, great player movement can create an opportunity just like that.
Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, in it forward, it's going to be Thompson and Wiggins. Stephen Curry's out there with Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Green in at the center, filling out the middle. Ayton a screen on Wiggins. Crowder with it. Now Green defending. Kept alive. Ayton. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. And the Suns lead by two. Outside, Green. Passes it to Thompson. Outside, Curry to take the lead. Crowder pulls it in. The Suns shooting at 51%. Really solid. Ball outside. Ayton a screen on Curry. Here's Paul. Green with the block. Here's Curry with the three. Crowder pulls it in. Crowder's got five rebounds tonight. He dishes it to Paul. Back to Crowder. He kicks it to Paul. Shoots over Curry. And he overshot that one, missing. And so Green will bring it up for the Warriors. Trailing by two. Curry with it. Thompson outside to take the lead. Hits it from three-point range. Thompson's got the lead up to one now for the Warriors.
And Klay Thompson, one of those guys where you hit the switch as a lights-out shooter.
Pass to Crowder. To the paint. Here's Ayton. Good for his ninth make in just 12 shots. That's an even 75% shooting.
And that was the right call. When you need a basket, go to the guys you trust the most.
Yeah, whether it's teammates or the coaching staff, hopefully a combination of both, but gets close, he's getting the ball.
Neither team here in the fourth generating a lot of separation.
Yeah, it's been a close one. Five times the lead has switched hands thus far.
Here's Paul. Oh, they get it back. Kicks it out to Johnson. Good ball movement here by the Suns. Pass to Bridges from downtown. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Bridges. The Suns making a change here. Booker's checked in. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Curry against Paul. Green kicks to Thompson. Curry on the wing. Green with a screen on Crowder. Tries from 10. And the rejection by Ayton.
Oh, man, 7-1. Not a good idea to challenge Ayton there.
Ball against Wiggins. Bridges outside. Ayton a screen on Thompson. Ayton the pass to Bridges. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. The Warriors have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Paul against Curry. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Curry's got 11 in the second half.
What work from Steph Curry. Gets open and makes it look easy. Wow.
That was a second look at our Mobile One Drive. Amazing control on display.
And a close game like this, you've got to dig deep and just find a way to make things happen.
Yep, that one goes in there.
That's why Devin Booker has the ball for moments just like that.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. They're in front by two. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter. Poole's checked in for Dante DiVincenzo. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
Hey, guys. Well, Steve Kerr talked to his team during the last timeout. He said, this is what we play for, fellas. Let's knock them on their heels right out of the timeout. Show them how much you want it. Go get it. He really is fired up about this game.
Thank you, David. Green with a screen on Paul. Curry can't get it to go. The Suns trailing. Bridges outside. Booker looking around. Over Thompson. Booker no good. Golden State's gone 2-5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And Thompson kicks to Curry. From deep three-point range, that one misses. And Phoenix will come the other way. Booker outside. 103 left in the game. Aitner's screen on Curry. And here's Booker from the arc. Nails the triple.
Man, I'll tell you what, the pressure is cranked up. Who better to call than this guy?
Curry with it. Now guarded by Booker. Curry kicks to Poole. On deep. And the Warriors miss again.
He missed that one, but I've seen him drill shots from that distance in warm-up.
Oh, no, I know he can make it, but that's warm-up. So maybe just a step too far.
Aiton the screen. Booker up top, guarded by Curry. And the Warriors rip possession here. It's a one-point game. Green with a screen on Paul. It's Curry outside. No good from three-point territory. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
And he commits the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that will put them up by two.
And Chris Paul continues to affect every aspect of the game. He knows how important this time is. It's just incredible.
So he gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
Huge free throws, bumps the lead up to three, and now they simply have to guard against the three ball.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. They're trailing by three. 8 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. What do you think, guys?
And if you can get a three, shoot it. Otherwise, get the quick two and a foul.
Don't force something up. You got to be smart here.
From long range, can't knock in the three. They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul.
Well, you have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
At the line for Phoenix, Devin Booker taking two shots.
He hits the first one, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
The pressure is on, but Booker can handle it. He just has to trust himself.
And so both free throws are good, and it's a five-point game.
Breathe easy now. The biggest free throws in the game, and he's coming through.
So the Suns win it. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans, but in the end, everyone satisfied.
I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on, but let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And that'll do it, folks. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, DeAndre Ayton.